sing this song. It ain't about anything. It's about everything. Nothing at the same time. Ooh, you see, it's payday.
I was about to go to that bar and get me a drink.
Oh, I know, right?
Come on,
let's get weird. That was Shamar Allen on the Twist Stage. We love Shamar.
Yeah.
It's the time of the year when folks start thinking about the gifts they're going to get for family and friends. But who thinks about the gifts for thousands of children around the world who never receive holiday presents?
Yeah, unfortunately, there is one organization that will make sure that millions of gifts will be sent to children in need around the world. And it all starts with a shoebox. Mm-hmm. Twist reporter Kayla Bertuzzi has more.
In Cameroon, Africa, these children are elated as they open gifts filled with toys, school supplies, and hygiene products. And it all started with a simple shoebox. At New Orleans Baptist Theological Seminary, organizers say they've been a collection center for this project known as Operation Christmas Child since 2002.
We are into our 16th year. In that time, we've collected almost 250,000 shoeboxes as generous people from Southeast Louisiana have dropped them off.
Each year, volunteers from around the country help fill and donate shoeboxes to Samaritan's Purse, an organization that sends the boxes to countries around the globe that are affected by war, disease, and famine.
This is a great opportunity to show the love of God to children throughout the world, especially those who are living in circumstances where life is tenuous and they don't know about tomorrow. They know that somebody loves them and cares for them.
Rita Hansen is a local volunteer who has traveled to see Operation Christmas Child fulfill its mission.
The kids smiled and held up things. We told them what things were and we helped them play with their toys. It was really amazing.
Hansen says seeing these children firsthand helped her realize the true reason for the season, and that is giving to those in need.
We have a lot of stuff in the United States. We have more stuff than we need. And that's what was heavy on my heart when I came home, is that I'm just surrounded by stuff and I should put more of my efforts into helping those who don't have anything.
Her stories always make me want to cry.
Yeah, I know.
But here is an example of the shoebox. You can go to SamaritansPurse.org for more information. You have until Monday to fill the box, and you can drop them at one of the 9 locations in the New Orleans area. But you just want to fill them full of goodies for people.
I know.
So
I mean,
sweet.
Those kids are so appreciative. The parents are, you know, to help kids that are in need. I think that's a wonderful thing.
It's absolutely. And I mean, think you could like raid a dollar store.
Yeah.
Imagine the damage you could do
right
at the dollar store with this cute little box. So if you're in a position to help, please do so.
Please.
All right. Whether in the stands or marching on the field, one of the best parts of a high school football game
is the band.
And every week we showcase some of the best bands around.
Yeah, and tonight Twist co-host LBJ is hanging out with the Bulldogs from Lutcher High School.
Just as the river parishes are home to diverse groups of Louisianans, so too does the Lutcher High School Band deliver that diversity on game day.
If you watch us on the field, you'll see that we're core style on the field, but when we're in the stands, we play a lot of pop music and rap tunes. I think it's because we're so versatile that makes us the best band in the land.
When director of bands Leslie Holmes arrived, she made a choice, Lutcher Band, to be less show and more substance. At the core of that best band in the land is a commitment to developing great players first and having a pride in execution on their instruments.
What's most important is their musicianship. So I think the marching style still goes together with the type of music that they like to play.
Undoubtedly, there's always fun associated with band in any school. And along with that fun is unquestionably a love for the music.
Music is everything to me. Like, when I run, I listen to music. When I'm in class, supposed to be doing work, I'm listening to music. It helps me de-stress, and that's how I get through most of my days.
For Director Holmes, seeing these young people blossom as a result of band pays immense rewards.
As a music educator, I get a chance to see my students grow up. And I've had some kids come in that were very shy, some with some issues with anxiety, low self-esteem, and just by the act of playing music and gaining confidence in their abilities to play music, they gain confidence in other areas of their life.
Very cool. And like I told people before, I used to play trombone, but the band was not as cool as these bands that we've been seeing.
I mean, never have I felt like so unimpressed with myself. I feel like an underachiever after watching those kiddos.
No.
So talented, yeah. so incredibly talented.
For sure.
And if you'd like to see more great high school bands, tune in every Friday night for Friday Night Football. Sports director Ed Daniels and coach JT Curtis will have all the game highlights. It starts at 11 on NOLA 38, the CW, with a replay at midnight right here on WGNO.
All right, Don Quixote is the story of a man who goes a little crazy, becomes a knight, and tries to rid the world of evil. Well, now there's a new film called The True Don Quixote, and it brings the story to life. The movie was shot locally, mostly in St. Bernard Parish, and recently won an award at the New Orleans Film Festival. Yeah, so I talked to the film's director and one of its stars about the modern twist on this classic tale.
The True Don Quixote debut had a sold-out crowd at the New Orleans Film Festival, drawing attention to the fresh idea of Don Quixote.
It's never actually been made into a feature film, although we ended up in a race with Terry Gilliam. It took him 25 years, but he made a version, but his is very different. We just made Don Quixote. Like, we changed the time and the place, but it's a pretty straight up telling of the story that's in the book. It's a little like Napoleon Dynamite, but Don Quixote's the beginning of all of this stuff. It's the first buddy comedy.
The film takes place in St. Bernard Parish, giving opportunity to local actors like Anne Mahoney, who's appeared in The Walking Dead, to shine on the big screen.
I feel very much part of this culture and these people, and it's my home now. I don't want to live anywhere else. I play Janelle Kehoe, the niece of Daniel Kehoe, AKA Don Quixote. Just to see this man who says enough with life as it is, who's tired of not having adventure and not having any glory in his life, and he goes out, and in that process, he picks up all these jaded people who probably have given up on life themselves, and they've lost their sense of purpose, and he gives them a sense of purpose.
I just thought I could just make the story. It's the most published book in the world after the Bible, so the story, you know, you'd hope would hold up.
Such a great movie, and you know, I saw it. It is absolutely hilarious. It tells a great story. You see a lot of St. Bernard Parish in there, and we can't forget about Quixote's sidekick, Sancho.
Yeah, oh my God. I'm your Pancho?
Sancho.
Sancho
Panzo.
Okay. Yeah. That's me to you, okay?
Panza. Panza, yeah.
I always look for an excuse to talk about ponchos, okay?
All right, well, the film, y'all, doesn't have a release date yet, but it's going through the film festival circuit, so hopefully it'll be out there soon.
How lucky that you've already seen it, Jabari.
Yeah, I know. It was so good. It was a sold-out crowd, too. All right, well, coming up, you're not going to want to miss our viral video of the week.
It's real good.
Stick around.